consumers and they're coming here.
Good morning, Ben.
Mrs. Tucker. What's wrong with the bells? Yeah. It's probably just the wind.
I've baked a little something for you and Harold. Some triple chocolate chip fudge brownies.
Mrs. Tucker.
Babacorn?
Mrs. Bagley.
What have you done to those bells?
Nothing. It's the wind.
You horrible little boy.
This is today's sermon. I've written it out nice and big so it's easy to read.
My glasses. Dear boy, I can't see a thing without my glasses. Glasses.
Okay. Go down and have a closer look.
What? Wait! There could be humans on the other side!
Don't care, don't scare me.
They terrify me. And besides, you know I haven't passed my dematerialization test yet.
I've told you before. It's all a matter of focus. Just watch and learn.
Okay, coast is clear.
Just watch and learn.
Heard that.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join together in holy matrimony. We are gathered here today to mark the sad passing of...
Oh, come on, Noshi, we haven't got all day.
You can do it. You can do it. You can do it.
I told you I couldn't do it.
We will now sing hymn number 45.
Just relax. Let go with your mind and body.
Do it.
Horrible noise! It makes my teeth hurt!
Noshi, will you get through this door now?
I can't!
If you don't find a way out of that room, I'm going to leave you behind!
Wearing a dress must be in charge. Does it look like he's in charge?
There's a boy. Maybe he's on trial. Because we took the wheels off his bicycle. Or could be.
This is the second time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why these persons should not marry each other, then you are.
Do you think he saw us?
Now.
Before you go, we still need some more clothes for the jumble sale. All donations will be greatly appreciated. And I'm sure you'll be pleased to hear that I've managed to persuade Mrs. Tucker to do a repeat performance of last year's excellent refreshments.
Stopped.
Shh.
Humans are leaving. Trial must be over.
Bald Badger's Benevolent Fund. Bald Badger's Benevolent Fund. Ah! Come along, Harold. Time for your mitzvah.
Violet, do I have to? I'm feeling so much better. It tastes so horrid.
It's meant to taste horrid. It's medicine.
Oh, no, you don't, Christopher Tucker. Pea shooter, please.
Oh, come on, Mum, it was a laugh.
Oh, yes, I'm sure Mrs. Bagmini found it hysterical. Now sit there, quietly, until I'm ready to go.
Music thing that's made of wood make music like you really should.
Christopher.
Stop me, I'm not even touching it. I think he saw us.
Christopher, I'm warning you. You are in serious trouble, young man. Just wait till I get you home.
Mom!
How did you get up here? This is private property.
Don't worry, you can't see us.
What are you talking about? Of course I can see you.
You must believe in witches.
Witches? You're not witches.
What, don't we look like witches?
Just because you dress a little eccentrically doesn't make you a witch. What's wrong with your dress?
Nothing. What's wrong with yours? Why are you wearing your collar backwards?
Because I'm a man of the church. Look, you've still not told me how you got up here.
We flew.
Oh, don't tell me, on a magic carpet.
No, broomsticks.
Oh, broomsticks. Oh, of course, broomsticks. Then where are they?
Oh, we haven't got them anymore. Miss Abercrombie confiscated them.
Oh, how inconvenient.
So we're stuck here now.
Stuck? Oh, I see. And who exactly is Mrs. Abercrombie?
Well, she's the Queen of Witch Island, where we used to live.
Okay, where are you really from? London?
Well, it's true, we're witches.
You just ate that bad.
I was hungry.
Now look, I don't know where you've come from, and I don't know who you are.
Well, I'm Skirty Mum, and this is Old Noshy.
Skirty Mum and Old Noshy. Well, it's a pleasure making your acquaintance, but you can't stay here.
Well, why not? I mean, what possible harm could we do?
It's not that simple. This is a small village, and well, it looks sure you've both got homes to go to.
We vanished.
Vanished?
For a whole century. 100 years.
Yes, I know what a century is.
Please, can we stay?
Please. We have nowhere else to go.
No. No, it wouldn't be a good idea. Besides, it's not very comfortable, is it?
Oh, I don't know.
Please.
Maybe. Just for a few days.
Oh, you'll not regret it. Thank you.
I think I already have. So, right, well, where are your things then? Luggage, change of clothes.
We haven't got any.
Right. Oh, wait here and I'll see what I can do. Ben Abercorn. Either they're crazy. Where you are?
It's
told you Dirty Groggs was wrong about witches being burnt at the stake.
Just because we have met one nice human does not mean they are all like that.
Anyway, burnt will be the last of our problems. Probably get dumped in the pond first.
What?
That's how they tell if you're a real witch or not. Real witches float.
Well, I don't. I can't swim.
Well, that's all right then, isn't it? You're obviously not a real witch. Did you hear that?
Scott, it's the humans. They've come to get us.
No, don't be silly. It's probably that nice one coming back with some clothes for us.
Hello? Is anybody there?
Quick, hide!
Where?
Chris, what are you doing up here? You know it's out of bounds.
I thought I heard someone up here.
Chris, I don't want to have to tell your mother. Well, there's nobody here now.
I'm sure I heard something.
My, lunchtime. Your mum will be wondering where you are. Go on now. I'll have a quick look round.
But I'm certain.
Yes, run along now.
I wish you'd let me do that. I feel like a firelighter.
What's his problem?
Don't know. Not very attractive, is it?
Witches, you're witches. You really are. Did that boy see you?
No.
Good. Good, that's good. The less people... Yes, it's the less people that know about you, the better. My, is that the time? A moustache.
No, don't go.
Well, it's nearly lunchtime. Mrs. Bagmeanley will kill me if I'm late.
Who's Mrs. Bagmeanley? She your wife?
No. No, she's Harold's cousin. She nurses him. He's not been well.
Oh, that's nice.
No, it isn't. She's only after his money, poor Harold, and she practically starves us.
That's horrid.
Yeah, she's a real witch. Not that that's... Well, anyway, just be thankful you'll never have to meet her. I nearly forgot.
Another 5 seconds, and your dinner would have been in the bin.
Sorry, I was sorting out clothes for the jumble sale.
Oh, it's about time you started pulling your weight around here.
Harold is not at all well. Between you and me, I'm not sure how much longer he's going to be with us.
Oh, Harold, there you are. How are you feeling?
Oh, you know.
Come and sit down. Lunch is ready. Open wide.
I've had my medicine.
That was the nasty yellow one, Harold. This is the very nasty brown one you have before meals. Oh, gone. Now, that wasn't too bad, was it? Healthy eating leads to a healthy body, leads to a healthy mind. You'll be right as rain in no time.
Bene de domine nos et hic tua grata, que tua lara gitate sumus sumpturi. Amen.
Mrs. Tucker's made us some triple chocolate chip fudge brownies. They're in the church.
Dear boy.
No, I couldn't.
Surely you can force down a little bit more.
No, honestly, I couldn't eat another thing.
Good. Then you won't want any of this then, will you? amazing what people leave behind them in church. It's no good looking at me like that, Harold Snelling. Just think of all that chocolate clogging up your arteries.
I think I'll go and have a lie down.
Good idea. You go and have a little nap. And what are you staring at? There's a sink full of washing up waiting for you. Oh, and Ben, you'll never get the better of me, so don't even think about it. Well, temper, temper. If you don't like it, you can always leave.
And leave Harold to your tender mercies. I think not.
Have you seen anyone?
Nah. Must all be this lunch thing. Human alert!
It's not funny.
Not. You've got lots of exploring.
Scotty, that boy's behind us.
I know.
What do you mean you know?
He's been behind us since we left.
Do something, get rid of him.
Okay. Nature, bring a mini twister to rid us of this nosy mister.
Door before me, vanish away, come back on another day.
Harold, is something wrong?
Are you leaving us?
No. Whatever gave you that idea?
I heard you talking to Violet. Dear boy, I don't think I could manage without you.
Harold. I promise you, I'm not going anywhere.
Ooh. And how come I get this mangy thing?
Well, because these are a lot more difficult to play.
You just made that up?
Broomstick of domestic need will now become my trusty steed. No more to sweep the dirty floor, but to fly with me forevermore.
Station alarm showing a break-in at Tranter's End General Store. I'm heading there now. Stand by to offer immediate backup.
Hey, look. It's a picture of our new home. It's a postcard.
How do you know?
Oh, I learned about it in human lessons. Apparently you send these to people to tell them you're having a lovely time.
I'd send one to Mrs. Abercrombie then. Boy.
Boy.
Don't move. Stay where you are and put your hands in the air. Christopher Tucker. I might have guessed.